commentator. I know, I know why I'm here. We're gonna do this wrestling style, if you guys don't mind me. I'm gonna need a lot of cheers. First up, please welcome to the stage the creator of Tekken, the one and only Harada Son and Michael Murray! Next up, you know him as WWE Superstar Xavier Woods. I know him as Austin Green as well. Please welcome to the stage, Xavier Woods!
Baby!
Next up. Let's welcome to the stage the only Grand Slam champion in MMA history, the legendary Chris Cyborg! And last, but certainly not least, and I'm actually kind of tongue twisted and scared that I even get to do this, please welcome to the stage, Iron Mike! Jump right into it and start talking about, you know, what this panel is going to be about here, because, you know, what we want to do is we just want to talk about the passion that we have for fighting, whether it's making video games, being a professional wrestler, an MMA fighter, and of course a legendary boxer. We just want to talk about this cool thing and share this experience with y'all. So let's go ahead and do this, shall we? First things first. Obviously, the spark to fight began somewhere, but let's actually talk about the origin stories for everyone here. First, for Harada-san as well as Michael, you know, the inspiration to...
Alright, I started fighting when I was 12. I was in a reformatory for boys, and then one day Muhammad Ali came to visit us. And I said, wow, just like in here, and he came out. I said, I want to be like him. Then a couple of months later, I watched Roberto Duran fight Sugar Ray Leonard in 1980. I said, this is what I want to do with my life, and this is why I'm here now.
Wow. Mike, if you don't mind me asking, what was it about, you know, obviously, you know, besides it being Muhammad Ali, but what was it about him as a boxer that inspired you as well to want to pursue that craft?
Susie went in, everybody went crazy.
Wow. I like that. That's incredible stuff. Now, obviously, you know, there has been a lot of, like, evolution and growth, obviously, in the craft over the course of the years, right? Whether it's, you know, making the game and how advanced games have become, or professional wrestling and how far that has gone. Same thing for MMA and boxing here. So I think what would be interesting to hear is, you know, how do you view, I guess, your start? If you can go back and say, like, hey, I would like to try something different. I guess we'll start with our panelists over here real fast, and we'll talk to the devs after. Woods, I'll start with you, if you don't mind. If you can go back and be like, hey, I want to try and make some changes here. You know, maybe protect my body a little bit more. What were some of the things that you kind of, like, pulled away from your experience that you would love to go back and tell your former self?
I don't know. I feel like that's always a weird question, because I feel like the things that you did, the mistakes that you made, have turned you into the person that you currently are today.
Awesome.
You get to shape yourself, and so I don't know what I would tell myself. Maybe don't get as down on yourself as you used to, because doing something like professional wrestling, it's one of the hardest things in the world to become successful at, because the field is so huge, there's so many people that are involved in it. And there have been times where I just didn't think that I could keep going. I didn't think that I was gonna be as good as I wanted to be. There's the times where I didn't think I could be as technical or as sound or as strong or as fast, all those things. But you push through and you persevere, and that's how you become a champion, you know? So I probably just told myself to give myself more grace.
Stay on the path.
Yeah, man.
Okay, Chris, what about for you? Because obviously, you know, starry-eyed young kid, get an opportunity, someone watch you play handball, and they're like, you can fight. So what happened there?
You know, for me, I feel like it's a gift to be a fighter. I think I never had a plan, but as I was an athlete, I was prepared for something I didn't know what it was going to be.
Yeah.
So I think all the sport at 12 years old, it took 19. I play sport to make who I am. And of course, I stay a long time undefeated, but I believe like when you get a loss, my first loss, I learn a lot.
Yeah.
So making me improve and get experience of who I am today. And I think it didn't change anything, you know? I think everything affects you, like you said. You learn from your lesson, your mistakes, and you get better and be better fighter.
Makes sense. Yes. Mr. Tyson?
I don't know. I was hard on myself. I was fighting. Everything was fighting. My whole life was fighting. I had nothing else. Nothing. I had to be the best ever. And that's what I just wanted to be. I just wanted to be who I am today.
That's it. Awesome. Awesome stuff. Now, obviously, for you guys, you know,
I lived it, I breathed it every single day that I could watch it. I was obsessed with it. And when I realized that I could possibly put on my shiny pants and I could be flown around the world and someone else is going to pay for it, I can have all these crazy experiences that I might not have otherwise in life. I said, I have to do this. And so that's when I started amateur wrestling and got into track and field and football and played all these sports so I could turn into an athlete, a real athlete, so that I could eventually become a professional wrestler. And now, next year, it'll be 20 years in the game.
Great to be able to hold that. And Chris?
Good afternoon for everyone. For me, I started to play sports in school. I really enjoy. I play handball, soccer, I play basketball. And then I never think I'd be a fighter. I never have a dream. I was an athlete. And then one guy saw me play handball and they talked to me after. He said, I think you can be a great fighter. I said, I didn't like fighting. He said, no, come to the gym. You're going to like. So I started training in Shootabout Gym. And in 6 months, I started I did my first fight. I lost my first fight, but I see how much I have inside me. I say, man, I want to finish the fight, do my best I can. And here I am, 18 years doing this, the only Grand Slam champion in sports, and I love it. I love it. I have passion.
Amazing. Of course, for you, my friend.
Ellie Seckback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.